In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek our protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of the sickness and death. Restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for the disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by our guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers, that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through the Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen.
Amen.
Our Lady, Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calunsod,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony of Padua,
pray for us.
Amen. Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. We are now celebrating the second Sunday of Easter and the Divine Mercy Sunday. Our Mass presider is Father Bipin John. Like newborn infants, you must long for the pure spiritual milk that in Him you may grow to salvation. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Grace and peace to you from God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ,
and with your spirit.
Like the Apostle Thomas, we want to see clear signs of Jesus' victory over death and corruption. May the Lord open our eyes to the power of His resurrection and transform our doubts and fears into confident faith and boundless joy. This octave day of Easter is also Divine Mercy Sunday, promoted by Saint Faustina Kowalska, whom Pope John Paul II canonized on 30th April 2000. The devotion to the Divine Mercy is a perennial invitation for us to face with confidence in divine goodness the difficulties and trials of both the present and the future. Brothers and sisters, we remember all our parishioners, all those who offer this holy mass for various intentions. We remember them and pray for them. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned against you. Show us, O Lord, your mercy and grant us your salvation. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to the people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God.
Heavenly
King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High,
Jesus Christ.
With the Holy Spirit, glory of God, the Father. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindled the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possession was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
I was hard-pressed and was falling, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. The joyful shout of victory in the tents of the just.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. You believe in me, Thomas, because you have seen me, says the Lord. Blessed are those who have not seen me, but still believe. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Holy Word of Gospel, wipe away all our sins. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, the second Sunday of Easter is Divine Mercy Sunday. Pope Francis declared Jubilee Year of Mercy that started on December 8, 2015. In his bull presence, Jesus as the face of the Father's mercy. And he notes that mercy is greater than sin. And he highlights the unconditional love of God. The God who is ever ready to forgive. On the evening of the first day of the week, Jesus stands in the midst of the fearful disciples. His first word to them is Shalom, peace, peace be with you. In peace there is forgiveness and reconciliation. He gives them the power to bring this forgiveness to people. He breathes on them the Holy Spirit. Pope Francis reminds that we can be messenger of peace. We have received the peace of Christ, so now we have to take that peace to others. Pope Francis invites the people of God, let the church be the place of mercy and hope, where everyone is welcome, loved, and forgiven. The church is the place of obtaining God's mercy through the sacrament of reconciliation, through the corporal works of mercy, through the spiritual works of mercy, and above all, through the Eucharist, which embodies the sharing of the passion, death, and resurrection of Jesus, and the fellowship of communion in the church. And he says, we have a shining example of this is Saint Teresa of Calcutta. Thomas looked up to the wounded Lord and made his peace, my Lord and my God. Brothers and sisters, we may also have many questions about our faith, about the church or anything. Maybe we can approach some of our theologians and clarify our questions and become good, deep, strong in our faith. Tayopo ai nasa ikalawang lingo nang pasko nang muling pagkabuhay ni Kristo Jesus. Ipinahayag ng ating Papa Francis ang taon ng banal na awa simula noong ika, walo ng Disyembre 2015. Ipinakita ang mukha ni Kristo Jesus bilang simbolo ng awa at nagpahihiwatig na ang awa ng Panginoon ay mas higit at maging ibabaw upang lupigin ang kasalanan at walang katumbas ang walang hanggang pagmamahal ng Diyos na handang magpatawad. Noong gabi ng upang araw na nagpakita si Kristo Jesus sa kanyang mga takot, natakot na mga alagad ang una niyang batisa sa kanila ay shalom. Kapayapaan ay sumainyo kapag may kapayapaan. May pagpapatawad at panunumbalik sa Diyos at pagkakasundo ng mga nakakagalit at nakakatampuhan sa pamamagitan ng banal na Espiritu. Binigyan ni Kristo Jesus ng kapanggariyahan ang kanyang mga alagad na magpatawad. Sinabi ni Papa Francis na tayo rin ay maging misyonero ng kapayapaan noong muling nabuhay si Kristo Jesus. Ito ang pangunahing kalaban ng kasalanan. Nag-aanyaya si Papa Francis sa ating mga Kristiyano na gawin natin ang simbahan na pook ng awa at pag-asa na kung saan dito lahat ay malugod na tinatanggap, minamahal at napapatawad. Ang simbahan ay ang lugaro pook upang makamit ang kapatawaran sa pamamagitan ng sakramento ng panggugumpisal at paggawa ng kabutihan sa kapwa nating mga kapatid at higit sa lahat ang pagdalo sa Eucharistia na kung saan nakikibahagi tayo sa pagpapakasakit, pagkamatay at muling pagkabuhay ni Kristo Jesus. Si Santa Teresa ng Calcutta ay katangi-tanging halimbawa na maaari nating tularan. Tiniyak ni Thomas na ang Panginoon ang kanyang kaharap sa pamamagitan ng magasugat sa katawan ni Kristo Jesus. Nawala ang kanyang pag-aalinlangan, nakaroon siya ng kapayapaan at sinabi, Panginoon ko at Diyos ko. Brothers and sisters, let us profess our faith. I believe in
God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, in Jesus Christ, his only Son and our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Let us turn to the Father through our Lord Jesus Christ, who plunges us into the infinite ocean of his mercy that is greater than sin, evil, suffering, and death. In his loving mercy, we have victory, salvation, and eternal life. Our response, God of mercy, listen to our prayer.
God of mercy, listen to our prayer. For the leaders of the church, that believing in and experiencing the Lord's infinite mercy, they may always proclaim it to God's people, we pray.
God of mercy, listen to our prayer.
For our local and national leaders, that like the apostles, they may attend to the needs of our communities and work for peace, unity, and progress, we pray.
God of mercy, listen to our prayer.
For those who, like Thomas, live in doubt and fear, that peace and forgiveness of the risen Christ may strengthen them to face life's challenges and difficulties, we pray.
God of mercy, listen to our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, that we may be immersed in the ocean of divine mercy and live as ministers of the Lord's peace and reconciliation, we pray.
God of mercy, listen to our prayer.
For our departed brothers and sisters, may they experience the infinite mercy of God in the heavenly paradise, we pray.
God of mercy, listen to our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
God of mercy, listen to our prayer. God our Father in Jesus, you have shown us your boundless love and infinite mercy. Teach us to love you in return and trust our lives to your love and mercy, and serve you in our brothers and sisters through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of our human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of our human hands. It will become a spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Let us pray. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, a duty and a salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Broderick, our administrator, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, it is good to have devotion to divine mercy. Every day 3 o'clock, in a special way, Friday 3 o'clock, 30 minutes, Rosary of Divine Mercy and Prayer of the Divine Mercy. When we have good devotion, many miracles takes place in our personal life and also in our family. This is the time where the whole world needs peace because of the situation, because of the pandemic. We ask the Lord that he may pour out his Spirit upon the whole world, that we may all enjoy Lord's mercy and good health. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you, brothers and sisters. Peace be with you, brothers and sisters. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to all of us who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Amen. The body of Christ. Amen.
Amen. Bring your hand and feel the place of our nails, and do not be unbelieving, but believing. Alleluia. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
what has passed, lips has put, O Lord, may possession, purity of heart, that what has been given to us time, may be a healing for eternity. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. Amen.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
Amen. And may you who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Amen.
Go forth. Our celebration is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Salamat po. God bless you all.
Sa ngalan ng Ama at ng Anak at ng Espiritu Santo. Amen. O San Antonio, pinili ka ng Diyos na ipabatid sa daigdig ang iyong kabanalan upang maakit ang marami sa paggawa ng mga kabutihan. Hilingin mo sa sanggol na si Jesus na hawak mo sa iyong bisig ang mahigpit ko ngayong pangangailangan. Samahan mo ako sa aking panalangin, sapagkat ang dasal ng isang banal na kagaya mo ay dinirinig ng Diyos. Pagkalooban nawa ako ng Panginoon ng tanda ng kanyang pagmamahal, pagkalinga at paggabay. Sa tulong mo, naway ipagkaloob niya sa akin ang kaganapan ng buhay at ang pag-ibig na walang hanggan. Amen.